Hello students, welcome to the class of editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding warm contact, lukewarm outcome, written by Sohasini Haider. Now, in order to understand this editorial, we need to decode the title of this editorial. The title says warm contact. Now, is just a contact enough to solve all the irritants that we are having with China? Is just by staying in touch with China be enough to resolve our all disputes? Will the bonhomie between the political leaders be enough to resolve all the conditionalities that we are having in India and China relationship? Now, as far as the contact is concerned, we have a history behind it. India had a cozy relationship, India had a warm relationship, India had a brotherly relationship with China in the past, but that ended up in yielding a war with China. So the contacts alone will not do. Just by staying in touch alone would not do. Now, when we compare India with China, India is a minnow country. China is a country that possesses lot of economic prowess, that possesses lot of political prowess. Now, India being a minnow country, we need to deal with this country, which is a complete embodiment of political prowess. And because India is a minnow country, we want to resolve all our irritants, we want to resolve all our disputes, we want to resolve all our conflicts with China as soon as possible, because it is the conflict with China primarily that is stopping India from playing up a constructive role in the global landscape. In the global landscape, where the issues about the global democracy has to be decided, where the issues about the financial global democracy has to be decided, where the issues related to global terrorism has to be decided, where the issues about climatic change has to be decided. Now, India has failed to engage itself constructively because these two major irritants and conflicts, that is with China and Pakistan, are stopping us. Now, why China is not proactive in yielding the results? Why China is not interested in the outcomes, and why the response with respect to the outcomes is really lukewarm? Why the progress is procrastinating? Why the progress is slow? Why the talks that are going on are not yielding any result? We have sent n number of special representatives to China to resolve the conflict. At least 12 rounds of special representatives have met with each other, but still the outcome is not nearby. Now, why China is not interested? China is not interested because resolution of the conflict with China will give India a lot of leeway, will give India a lot of freedom, will give India an opportunity, will catapult India to the global landscape, and that is what China don't want. China wants India to remain embroiled. China wants India to remain engaged in the conflict, because in that case our energy will be bifurcated. We will not be able to utilize all our potential to develop India economically. Now, why there is a kind of dilution in the policies that the India is pursuing. We are actually not clear about what India has to do in the future. Militarily, we will not be able to engage with China. China is far, far, far ahead of India in terms of military engagement. So in that case, India wants the resolution of the disputes to take place as soon as possible. Now, how is that possible? This is a big, big question as far as the Indian diplomacy is concerned. How can we resolve the territorial dispute? How can we resolve the integrity that is lying actually bequeathed, that is lying actually mortgaged with China? This can be done if we will strengthen India. Now, how can the strengthening of India take place? Now, if you take the case of India and China, both these nations, they were actually at an equal pedestal. They were actually at the same level of the hierarchy. But China has moved far ahead. Because China has strengthened itself economically, politically, militarily. And the most important thing is that it has strengthened itself economically. And the same thing India has to replicate if we want to engage with China militarily in the future. Else it would be very difficult for us to yield any positive outcome. So this is all for this editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIAS Mentors. You can contact me at 845-940-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. You can also visit our websites. Name of the website is eiasmentors.com and brainiki.com. You can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainiki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. Please do share this video. In case you've liked it, do comment on this video. And the question for the day is critically analyze India and China relationship. And do analyze this relationship, keeping this editorial in your mind. So this is all for the day. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a nice night.